Hello friends, Dr. Poonam Sambhaji here, and today's question is from Maya Pradeep, who has been asking me this question on the YouTube channel, and the question goes this way. Again, I'm reading it. Hello doctor, you're doing a great job. Thank you, Maya. My question is that my son is 6 years old and whenever he travels in car, he starts vomiting. What should I do? Now, this is a problem which is very, very common in children, and children usually about the age of 2 years, you end up having a motion sickness. Now, this is called motion sickness, okay? And usually children about the age of 2 years will have it, and over time they will overcome it once they learn the preventive measures, and those preventive measures will be at the end of this video. So stay tuned to me till the end, okay? So let's take this topic in three major chunks. The first is, what exactly is this motion sickness? Second thing is, how exactly it happens, why it happens, okay? And the third thing is your treatment along with the prevention, that is the management of the problem, okay? Now, motion sickness is basically a feeling of dizziness and a feeling of nausea. Nausea means a feeling of vomiting, but you're not vomiting, you just feel like vomiting, okay? And the third thing is actual vomiting, that you vomit out everything. This whole stuff, all these three symptoms are called, all these three symptoms together are called motion sickness, and it is all because of a disturbance in the perception of balance in our body, the way the balance is perceived in our body. Now, all this occurs because a little bit of confusion at the vestibular system, which is a system which is there in our inner ear, that is the three parts of the ear. Ear has the external ear, that is outside, the middle ear, and the inner ear. So the internal ear or the inner ear is the place where this vestibular system is situated. If you want to know more about it, please Google for, or just check for, vestibular system for balance, okay? So that will give you all the information regarding the vestibular system. There are labyrinths in that, that's the part which is there, and that the fluid in that helps us knowing the balance of the body, okay? So whenever there is a disturbance in this, especially when you are when you are in a running vehicle, like a vehicle in motion, like in car, or you are in the plane, or you are on a ship, or even if you are on a swing, there can be problems of this balance, okay? So now let's, before knowing about the motion sickness more in detail, let's know how do our senses help us in knowing the position of the body, okay? Now, there are three senses, there are actually five senses, but three senses help us in knowing the position of the body. One is your optic system, wherein you see where I am. I'm standing, I'm sitting, I'm lying down, I'm turning, whatever, okay? The other thing is your ear. So even if your eyes are closed, you know that you're standing, you know that you're turning, you know that you're looking, you are walking forwards or you are walking backwards. You understand still because of the labyrinths inside the vestibular system inside your middle ear. And the third thing is your touch. Yes, your touch, especially the pressure points on the foot side, on the foot area of your body, wherein when you're walking, the pressure receptors which are there on the sole of the foot also helps you in knowing, yes, you're walking forwards, yes, you're walking backwards. Plus, there are receptors at the different joints, the tendons and all that. There are receptors even within that, okay? They also help you in knowing the position of the body, okay? So all these are the systems that you, that help you in knowing the position of the body. Now, take an example, okay, that you are sitting in the car and you are a driver, you are driving, and remember one thing, a person who has this thing, the motion sickness, now if he is an adult and he is driving, he will usually not have motion sickness. The reason is, when he's driving, he's looking steady forward, straight in one line, and the motion is the same that he sees is the same as the motion of his body, that is, he is going forwards, and yes, even the road is going forwards, it's driving forwards, okay? So he will usually not have a motion sickness. Motion sickness happens when there is a disturbance in all these movements across. Now take the second example. I'm sitting in the car and I'm a person who usually has a motion sickness. I mean, I don't have, I'm just giving example, okay? And I'm reading something, okay? So I'm reading. So according to my labyrinth, that is according to my internal ear, okay, I'm actually moving forwards. Okay, so I'm supposed to see something which is moving forwards. Okay, that is the road, the way you see road. I'm supposed to see something like that. Instead, my eyes are saying that I am at one place. That is, my eyes are seeing only one thing at a time. That is, it's seeing this page. And according to my eyes, I'm not moving. But according to my ear and according to my other senses, that is your touch senses, I'm actually going ahead in a car. So when these senses, that is my ear and my rest of the body, the senses, the touch senses, are telling my brain that yes, the body is moving ahead. But my eyes, my optic system is telling my brain that I'm in one place, I'm not moving, I'm just reading one this thing, okay, a book. So because of this confusion that is created in the brain cannot process the signals properly, and then you start having this dizziness, the nausea, that is feeling of vomiting, as well as vomiting at times, okay. So now this is the cause of that that motion sickness that you are talking about. Now Maya, specifically for you, so what you can do is few of these things. One thing is there are other things which can aggravate this motion sickness. One is poor ventilation. So many children will feel pukish or feel like vomiting with this motion sickness, especially if you are inside the AC. The car is closed and AC is on, they will feel like more like vomiting. So see that there is fresh air, okay. Second thing is overeating. Don't overeat and sit in the car. Eat very moderately, and if you're someone who anyway knows that you're going to vomit, then try to keep it bare minimum. It should be non-oily food, okay. It should be simple food, okay. Third thing is usually pregnant ladies will get it more often, and sorry, one more topic that I forgot here was anxiety. When you get it once, the second time again you will feel that, oh, I sit in the car again, I will get vomiting. So that anxiety itself can make you have that motion sickness again. Now coming to the treatment of this, the treatment is basically over the counter. For adults, you get tablets like Avomin, okay. So these are basically a promethazine medicine, is the promethazine. For children, you have to go to your pediatrician and find out the dose specific for your child, because they are dependent upon the weight of the child. But for adults, it's a single tablet. Now whether it is tablet or the syrup given to the children, remember one thing, it has to be taken 30 minutes to 60 minutes before your planned travel. So your planning of the travel should be is a must. You have to travel, you have to plan and travel, okay. So you have to give the medicine 30 minutes to 60 minutes before the traveling time, so that it can show its effect. At the same time, you should always remember, especially the adults, that such type of tablets are their side effect is is itself sleeping, okay. You feel very sleepy, so see to it that you are not driving after taking this medicine, you are not operating some machinery after taking this medicine. It can be dangerous, so avoid driving, avoid using machineries, especially harmful machineries, if you have taken these tablets, okay. Now coming to the preventive measures, which are most important, okay. So the first thing in the prevention is that you have to see that you are seeing in a direction that the motion is in. So the best seat for such a person to sit is the front seat, and tell the person to look at one point in the front, that is through the screen, through the windshield, look at one point, okay. And not that children usually like, okay, this tree is gone this side, I will see here, someone is gone this side, I will see here. That's why there are changes in the type of motion that is coming in front of the eye, and that's why they feel that pukish. So tell them, okay, look in front over there, so something is there in front of the car, tell them to look over there, so you know there'll be less chances. Second thing is giving the medicine 30 minutes to 60 minutes in advance. Third thing is that see to it specifically that they don't sit in the opposite direction. Now this is very common in those cars which have the back seat are facing each other, okay. Also in buses sometimes you have these seats which are facing the other side, that is the facing their back towards the driver's seat, okay. So in that case you are seeing the you are moving ahead, but you are seeing items, that is through your eyes you are seeing items from the back window of the bus, as if the things are going away from you, okay. So their things are going away, but you are actually moving ahead. Because of that confusion again, you can get vomiting. So try not to sit on those seats which are facing opposite the driver's seat. So if driver is looking in front, even you have to look in front. It should not be that you are looking behind. If you start looking behind, you will have this problem of vomiting. Another thing is children who just turn their, you know, seat anyways they want on the back seat also, they will start looking behind. They may feel pukish. Okay, then do not eat too heavy food before driving, getting inside the car or before traveling, so that you can avoid such type of vomitings. See to it that fresh air is moving. Other things that you can use is, many people feel better when they take ginger, you know, they bite on ginger or some ginger goli they take, or lemon if they smell lemon, or if they take amla for biting also they feel better. So this sort of stuffs also can be tried by you. Taking the medicine has to be after the advice from the doctor, because it has to be taken according to the weight of the child, and it has to be planned properly so that the child doesn't vomit. I hope that is the only thing I wanted to tell. Okay, one more thing is that as an adult, if you are having this problem, see to it that you learn to live with it. What I mean by that is learn to prevent it by the methods that I told you. And because prevention is much better than the treatment, because once you start feeling that dizziness, it's a very awkward feeling. I still remember when I had gone to Mahabaleshwar when I was small, I did have motion sickness that time, and I still remember that experience, which was not a good experience. Okay, so I hope, Maya, I have answered your question, and try to do these preventive measures which I told, and get back to your doctor and get the dose of the medicine at your hand, so that next time you are traveling you can give the medicine to the baby. Bye bye. Thank you for following me. Thanks for showing so much of love, and keep watching, keep asking me questions so that I can answer your questions, and increase the knowledge base of the parents. Bye bye.